Welcome, everyone, and if we could please have you stand and remove your cap for the playing of the national anthem.
You see, by the dawn's early light,
now, we'd like to have the starting lineups for the Southern Cayuga Chiefs. Number 11, Charlie Bennett.
I'm Geneva back here in Moravia.
And number 13, Alicia Oroma. Number 14, Circe Perez. Number 15, Emily Prince. And number 23, Nora McCarthy. And the rest of the Southern Cayuga Chiefs, they are coached by Ed Hessler.
Red jerseys with white numbers for Moravia. They're full white jerseys and navy blue numbers.
And now for your Moravia Blue Devils! Number 3, Olivia Jackson! Number 5, Kenny Hine! Number 11, Jordan Smith. Number 20, Ellie Kehoe. Number 22, Caroline Wesolewski. And the rest of the Moravia Blue Devils, they are coached by John Prosper.
Center circle, we're on top of the Blue Devils logo here. Referee's just making sure everything is all set here. Crowd here on hand. It's an earlier tip off than what was scheduled before. We're supposed to be at 6 o'clock at Southern Cayuga to have to change the location and the time for this game. So, wherever you are, we're going to drive them out from work or send it home. Thank you so much for tuning in to what should be a great Cayuga County Section 4. Contest. Tip off is underway. It's a Three sides early on. So they have Norm McCarthy in the ball. guarded by Pye. Bennett looking for an option. She dribbles, flings it, cross court over to Archie. Pass, pass. And trying to get it for Emily Prince with a kick goal violation on Jordan Smith. Seven on the shot clock. Of course, will restart due to the kick ball. So Southern Cayuga will inbound it here again with McCarthy on the right side of the baseline. Quickly get into Prince and a quick jump shot from the right. Nothing, 6:23 left in the first. Wasilewski coming in place of Chloe Hansen here. First free throw. Hi, Arkansas. So, rest of the starters, most of the starters last season, so the newcomer to the start. 6-2, the second free throw is also no good. Team foul, and that is against Kennedy McCarthy, her first team's fourth. row. June's coming out with a double-double, 10 points. Team's fourth of having a third. 6 to go, so referees are just having a quick discussion, perhaps about if she was that bounce from the vantage point, like what was on the line there. Keiko will inbound it either way for Moravia, right side of the basket. Sweet thing, that bounce pass to the left block for Hess, that is blocked. Yeah. Let's get Echo Scott Crossroads saying, take your feet, snap that time out, and keep your hands up. So that was actually Campbell. That's my apologies. We're setting down. Smith back in. Really quick. For her first points in the game. 8 points, 5 rebounds, and there's Susan O'Brien. Against Cooley Eldridge, 53-36 win. It's up for this time around here. So the 18th lead. Second difference in change makes it out of the game plan. This first quarter, Jordan Smith has it out there. On the logo. Not much movement going on here. Maybe an ISO call against Jessalyn Jones. We're just waiting for trying to attack. And out then it attacks. Fires out to Kennedy McCarthy. Back to Bennett. Three to shoot. Bennett, top of the order. Launches a deep three at the buzzer. Enter the second quarter. 18-10 lead over Moravia, rather. Over 7. Cayuga will take a quick time out. This is the second quarter of basketball on ESPN. Bennett has 7. Cayuga has 10. Yes. screen pass from left side of the lane. Fouled on the way up by Jordan Smith. Smith, good sportsmanship there. Comes out of the double. Number one. That is Smith's second foul of the game. Looks like they're going to make a change. Edges the game for the first time. And now she can come in. And only now. Lucy Arona is on. It's first appearance. Really new cover actually to this team. Two fouls. It's a free throw line here and 7 points, 5 boards. Too strong in that first free throw. Five so far. We have six, but that one short. 23-10 lead from Moravia. 5-11 to start the second quarter. Looking to make it more equal. Kehoe gets over to Jensen now. Near side. Now back out to the good pump. They got one. Jones. Second timeout. So, one big lane, one big lane, two big lane. Marcus did the game 30-12 and 19. Against the Blue Devils. Anymore this season for the boys and girls basketball. Once you get to the bonus, it's two free throws for names. We have Harvey, the sophomore, the lone sophomore in the team. Next to the 1.7 points game last season. Remember, this basketball is starting goalkeeper. Chiefs, season for that. Chance to hear for the Blue Devils. 3:41 left. 17.8. Now, Hess. Now finds Hess. Right block. Nothing. So again, inside the paint. 17.8 is the largest of the game. 22-13. McCarthy shoveling that stuff. Charlie Bennett to direct this offense. It's 2-3 shot. We're going to break it down. To Nora, almost high pass the left wing. Pass it there, and that's a Jensen, it's a right wing for Jones. Thought about it. Now gets to Cooper. He'll try a 3-4. Now 35-13 for Moravia. Steamrolling the Chiefs right now. Hand it off here to Perez. Now your corner for Kennedy. Parker backs out here. Crossboard pass. Risk it in over Parker. And catches it. Parker has a pass inside. But a jump shot. Reflections. Will be there. I was not to inbound it, but the referee says, not so fast. You see a road out to the game for Kennedy McCarthy from the Chiefs. Norm McCarthy, let's now, 2 minutes left in this second quarter. Jensen, 5-6-5, he gets inside, and a charge out by Hessel. And on top of the key, pulls it for three, can't hit. Jensen, two to go in this first half. Moravia working quickly with such an intricate passing here. That's a Jensen. It's a high now, right wing, and travel issue. moves to the side. This is going to be a lot back. That goes to 7-8. Back in here as McCarthy gets some instructions to Lucy Arona. Bring it up here. Jones and Long pass to Corbin. Corbin pass back out left loop for Perez. Back to Logo now for Bennett. By Jones finds McCarthy catching short through the left wing. Here. Off by him. It's the breakaway again. He's down the far side. Now puts up the break. It's going to be wide open top here. Three. Can't connect that side. Bennett, nice little Euro step bounce and in. Bennett, there's a few bounces off the field. Not an indicative movement from the junior. And now back to having a 20-point deficit. Coach, in the final minute here of this first half, 35-15 Moravia. Jones by Wild.
Thank you.
You're right. You're absolutely
thank you.
Tempo, fast-paced offense going again. Jordan Smith lead the way with 10 first-quarter points. He has been able to come to 6. Substitute Charlie Bennett leading the way for the team. By the way, the original starting 5 back shots. He's worried about the left-right in this second half. And jerseys for jerseys. Nice fast pass for Jordan Smith inside the Boston Muskie. Deficit would make it 13. And Southern Cuba could not imagine a better start to this second half here. Looking to keep it going. That's the third foul, by the way, on Gabby Hahn. And Bennett does get the Moravia, a little slow start here in these opening 30 seconds. 5-0 run to start the second half of Southern Cuba. Here now, down by 13. To Smith, though, looking to drive labels of a floater. Everything there is try to draw a foul on Cersei Pines there. To do so, it actually came off from Perez. So we'll stay with Moravia. He'll line down the right side of the basket. Looking, find Smith, jump shot, right side.
Thank you.
goes up. High arm, one of them. Jesselyn Jones, now then it looks to drive, spinning around, it's the first off, they're in past the bridge, now you're a corner for Nora Martin, back to the way down for Bennett, jump shot, mid range, no good, and Jones, Tita brings it up, Tita, playing for Smith, nice pass, pass inside, a good feed for Mazzaleski, couldn't put it up, and now Smith with the rebound, she left that one for two, now Bennett brings it up. Bennett driving away, right side of the lane, putting it to spin in, but it's a good foul. Foul on the way up. That's Kate's third foul of the game. The team's now with two in this third quarter. Bennett goes to the line for a pair, as well. Chase goes to the field, as Eric Black checks in for Lee Serrano. Bennett, 20 points.35 to go in this third quarter. Out 11 points. That's points. 16 rebounds. Incredible double double. He's going to be high, wide open, driving baseline. Far side gets it to the near corner, looking for Jones. Turns it over. We're going to say it came off for taking any risks as head coach Hannah Eslop. They cannot afford Charlie Bennett to bow out of this game here. So exactly 3 minutes left in this third quarter. Here with an 11-point lead, Rich Smith looking to extend it for a free throw line. This free throw goes short. Quarter action is sponsored by Mason Turner United Union. Change the way you think about making it. You can change your community. So a free throw from Smith. Emily Prince was trying to take it past the timeline on the far side. Ideal start there. Jones out the road. Jones. Fires over Smith right wing. Prince all over her. It's out now left wing for Jensen. Spin around. Right wing three. Put it out. Last time. This is it. Three to go in this third quarter, so we can get back in. A nice bounce pass to the left. That's out of bounds. Call a foul on Smith. Or no, that's what we did. It's Jensen that time. So it's the third foul in this quarter. Sign it's right to Gabby Heim, coming loose, and up by Olivia Jensen. Olivia right the other way. Pass over to Jones. That's a pass to Wasilewski for a high in. Taking the nice easy grab. Grabs in some trouble. Gets off down to Prince. Prince. I get past the timeline here. And timeout is called by Ed Heslop before they can commit a violation. The 30-second timeout is completed here. 2:30 left in this third quarter. 38-26 the lead from Moravia, so Southern Cayuga are out scoring Moravia by 6 points in this quarter. So again, they're working their way to trying to get it down to single digits by the end of it, as Moravia just a little bit off rhythm as compared with the first half. Third quarter action is presented by Thomas Wilkinson. Consider the focus basketball and by Gorgeous Graphics. He's fouled out. And that is the case. He's only been a foul. And she finishes with this incredible tally of 22 points. 22 points, and I have 16 rebounds. So the task to come back is just made that much more difficult. Charlie Bennett fouls out. 2:11 left in this third quarter. She's down by 12. All but four of their points have been scored by Bennett. This is a real test to see what the supporting cast can do now. To get this one, we can almost out the offensive line right now. Moravia has to step back and get it to the perimeter. Around the Smith now. Cross move back to Theo. Now Jones on top of the arc. Right to Wazileski to the side. Wazileski to the front over. That's Theo. Wazileski was able to get the three out by Jones. All cross moves since he went back to the front. Because that's a Smith to the line. Moravia having a bonus. So that's a bonus 7 in the game. And 2 free throws coming up from Smith, who still leads the team with 13 points. Stop the first free throw leaders back to a 13 point lead, 92 seconds left in the third quarter. So it's 2nd free throw. Smith came in as well, of course, the turnover. After a great start to this third quarter, we're all out of sorts now, as it's going to Arthur Jackson for Emily Prince. Now, exactly 90 seconds left in this third quarter. Brady with the ball up by 14. He bounced the left side of the basket. Jackson gets it to Keogh, far corner. Back out to Jones, top of the road. By a road, Jones finds Keogh, far side. Nice baseline, bounce back down with the left side. Misses his goal. Kale will take a pass to midcourt here. His pass
Smith now to Jensen.
Jensen. Now left wing three. Another deep one for Kehoe. Misses the mark there. Tipped out to Jones. Catching should be a point. And now it's Moravia's largest lead of the game up to 20 points. And now that one's ripped away by Kehoe from the lead. Jones takes it past the timeline. And timeout call by head coach John Prostro. No timeout, so we'll take a timeout as well. We're going to go in this one. Reserves on at this point. They're starting five, all the men. So obviously the job is done. Catches you near corner three. It's just short by Cooper. Gets on the rebound. And shot. Lead now back up to 19 for Moravia. This is Kennedy McCarthy. Gets it right wing for Arona. Right elbow now. A jump shot. Wild one from Erica Black. Yes, Nick the backboard. Rebound though by Fritz. Another jump ball inside the paint. So now, so you get what is that? Three jump balls in the span of a minute. You see something new every night. So, the things I've learned in my time in the area is section four. That's got to be a good one. And now, by the huge teammate. Save it. I'll tell you what, these Moravia reserves here are showing all effort and all hustle. And that's exactly what head coach John Prostro loves to see. Let's stay with Southern Cuba here. 2:35 left in this one by 19. Westbrook indeed, top of the arc three. This second round. Under 2 minutes left in this one. 53-34. That's actually the first foul of this. Pretty fast-paced fourth quarter as Lee Colden checks in for Lucio Rona. Norma Puckett. In that Prince. Long two on the far side. This is the side of the yard. Rebound was called out by left on the shot clock. I think they might have to reset that because once they got past midcourt, I think they didn't reset. Well, that's where the discussion is. And that's exactly what the official is. I thought he was going to do that, but let's see. Tremendously successful season. All the way to the regional final where they fell to Pembroke, powerhouse there at 8-man football, but still a great season. 6 points, leading up to 22. It's the final minute of this game. Results all but confirmed. It's Lily Coleman near side of the Star Varsity doing indoor track previously. Jump shot. Checks in for some cigarettes. First three throws on the Free throw, got it. 6:35, Moravia. 7 second interesting shot, game clock. Great way to open up. I see play, that's thrown away by him. That went really high. Great way to
Thank you.
at student Moravia High School for the post game show here on ESPN. We open up our coverage of the 64 winter season of girls basketball between Moravia and Cayuga. Moravia comes out in a thrilling style, 8:35 in that there. Rivals in that great game. Then have a great rest of your Thursday night.